Good morning, y'all, and welcome to today's video. My name is Amy, and I'm a patient of Live Healthy MD. I am 8 months post-op from gastric bypass, and I'm just gonna show you what I eat in a day. I've already taken my calcium chew, and I do use the ones from Celebrate. If you're curious about what kind of vitamins you should be taking, make sure you check out the video from our dietitian Morgan that's included on the channel. I am starting my day off with a cup of coffee, and I do put Benefiber fiber in my coffee. To me, it's just a great way to add extra fiber into my diet, and I can't taste it. So I would highly recommend that you try it if you're struggling to get fiber in your diet. It's a little bit after 9, so as soon as I finish drinking this, I'll show you my breakfast. Stay tuned. So it's time for breakfast, and today is a heavy gym day, so I am gonna have a slice of this Chompy's bread. It is only 2 grams of fat, 3 total carb, 2 dietary fiber, and 8 grams of protein. So all together, it's only 1 net carb per slice of this. And it's pretty good, but you do have to make sure that you keep it in the freezer. And you can get this from Sprouts. And I do try to stay under 40 carbs per day. So, you know, just make sure you're looking at, you know, your guide from your doctor, depending on what you can eat in the day. So here is my breakfast, my 2 eggs and my toast. So I'm gonna enjoy this. And I'll let you know what my total macros are for this meal. And I do use the Berrytastic app. Just wanted to show you what I have left on my plate, being a bariatric patient. You don't have to have a clean plate. I'll see you at lunch. So I wanted to talk about why I decided to have gastric bypass. So just to kind of give a little bit of background, I've struggled with my weight my whole life, as I'm sure most of you who are watching this video may have too. I can remember being 11 at my mom's baby shower for my younger brother and wearing a size 11 because we went shopping for new clothes. But in 2017, I finally committed to join a gym, track everything that I put in my mouth using my Fitness Pal. And with that, I lost about 60 pounds on my own. Now, trying to maintain that weight was the hardest thing that I could possibly do. So finally, at the beginning, maybe end of 2018 and the beginning of 2019, I decided to make an appointment. And this is what ultimately led me to my journey. I needed something to help me. Usually when I commit myself to something, mentally and physically, I commit 100%. But when I don't see the results, that's when I tend to fall off the wagon. So I don't know where you may be in your journey, but if you're struggling, you know, talk to your primary care physician. Talk to anybody that you can, maybe your family, somebody that you trust, but this was the option for me. Now, this is just a tool. Having surgery is not gonna be the end all be all. It's still a mental challenge. Okay, it is now time for lunch. So I have some shrimp right here defrosting. They'll be done really quick. I highly recommend, if you're looking for quick lunch ideas, having frozen shrimp in the freezer is a great option. So I'm just gonna do like a quick stir fry with a zucchini and some mushrooms. I'm also gonna be using mushrooms for dinner. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut those up now while I'm doing my lunch. That way I can save on prep later. I really don't like reheated food after surgery. So I don't meal prep. So it's completely up to you and how you feel. To me, I feel like the microwave changes the texture of food. I will reheat some things, but there's a lot of things that I won't reheat because I just can't stomach it. So I'm just cutting up my zucchini, cut it in half and then quartered it, and then cutting this up. I am gonna save a little bit of this for dinner too, just because this is a lot of food. I can't eat it all. So comment down below if you have frozen shrimp in your freezer, or what's the favorite item for you to have in your freezer for a quick meal ideas. Okay, I do have a scale here. I'm just gonna weigh out what I'm eating. Okay, 30 grams of zucchini, 20 grams of, these are bella mushrooms, cremini mushrooms, whatever you wanna call them. So I'm gonna add a pinch of salt, a little bit of onion powder, and I'm a Southern woman, I don't measure nothing. So if you want exact measurements, I'm sorry. And this is Trader Joe's umami. So I'm gonna put a little bit of that in there too. Okay, I'm gonna season my shrimp again with a little bit of salt. And I am gonna add a little bit of this tamari. Okay, there's lunch. Literally took me less than 15 minutes. So I'm gonna plate this up and I'll be right back. Okay, so here's lunch. I'm gonna eat it with my chopsticks. I kind of miss Japanese food, not a lot, but I find this is a way to, trick my brain that this is Japanese food. I don't have white sauce, I don't have rice, but I do have veggies and a meat. In this case, it's shrimp. But depending on where you are in your journey, if you have the macros for it, feel free to add like a side of rice, or a great alternative is cauliflower rice. That would be good with this too. But I'm just gonna go ahead and enjoy this, and this is gonna be my lunch. Okay, it's about 4 o'clock, and I'm gonna go ahead and start my dinner prep. I'm gonna be making a recipe out of this cookbook. And you can find this on Amazon. It's by Megan Moore. She also has an Instagram that you can check out as well. There's some really good recipes in here for pre-op, post-op, and then after as well. So I'm just gonna be making a meatloaf recipe. And then I'm also gonna be making a cauliflower mash. And I'm gonna be using some of the zucchini that I prepped before for a little side as well. So I have most of my stuff already prepped, so let's get started. Okay, so I have a pan heating up on the stove here. And when I do my meatloaf, I do like to saute my veggies before mixing it into the meat. So I'm gonna put a little bit of avocado oil in the pan. And I'm all about convenience. So I do have some frozen bell peppers out of the freezer. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of that in there. Okay, I'm gonna add in my mushrooms and my onions from earlier. And I may not put all of this in the meatloaf. I may use some of this for tomorrow, or throughout the week for an omelet. I'm gonna cook this down for a few minutes and then add some garlic. Okay, so I have my meat mixture all mixed up. So I have some additional ketchup and some Worcestershire sauce that I'm gonna put on top of the meatloaf. And it does take about maybe like 55 minutes to cook. So this is why I wanted to do it before I go to the gym. So I'm gonna get this into the oven for 55 minutes. Okay, I've got a little bit of water in my pot boiling. I'm gonna add my cauliflower. And I'm gonna cover this for about 8 minutes. My cauliflower is all steamed and ready to go. This recipe does call for low fat cream cheese or reduced fat cream cheese, but mine is no longer good and my other brick I already used. So I'm just gonna sub the cream cheese for sour cream. Still gonna probably taste the same. And I do have this fat-free sour cream that I'm gonna be using. Okay, so half a cauliflower in here. I'm gonna add in my cooked garlic. I'm gonna put a third a cup of grated Parmesan cheese. I'm gonna put 2 pinches of salt. I'm gonna add about 2 tablespoons of sour cream and see how it goes. The original recipe called for just 1 tablespoon of cream cheese. So here we go. That's really good. Okay, that's all for this. I have a few more minutes on my meatloaf and then I'll be ready to go. I have about maybe 40 minutes before I have to leave out the house for the gym. So at least my dinner will be ready when I get back. Okay, I'm getting ready to go to the gym. So my dinner's all done. I'll share my plate when I come back. I'm gonna eat this string cheese. This is from Kroger. But any kind of string cheese will do. I'm gonna snack on this before I go to the gym just to help me with some extra energy. Only the king, you know it. King already, you know it. Top everything, you know it. King already, you know it. My body's all got a king body. Body gon' shine, bling, bling body. Calling all the shots, ring, ring body. Crown on your head, got a king body. Don't live the king, you a king, you know it. Already, my baby, you know it. Okay, thank you for coming along to my workout today. My trainer doesn't want to be in the video. If you want to see him in videos, like it and subscribe. I'm so tired. We did the first 5 exercises twice and moved on to the second round. And then at the end, we did everything once. So as you saw, you can do a lot of things with just body weight. From what I've learned with working out with my trainer Corey. The only thing that we really use were these 10-pound dumbbells. So, if you're local to Augusta, check out Live Healthy MD. They have a lot of things like the gym that you see here. So if you want to come join me, call the front office. I am back from the gym and I'm gonna go ahead and eat my dinner because it's about 7:30. And it's getting a little late. So I wanna go ahead and eat my dinner. So I have my meatloaf. I have zucchini from earlier as well. And then I have my cauliflower mash. I might not eat all of this, but I did work out pretty hard as you saw. So I might be able to eat all this, I might not, it just depends. Okay, so I ended the day with 78 grams of protein with 15 net carbs, a total of 23 carbs. 676 calories, which is not a lot, but I did get in protein. I want to stay under 80, and I did end up with 28 grams of fat. So overall, today was a great day. There's always room for improvement, but I didn't go over my 80 grams of protein, and I'm still within my carb limit, even with having the bread and the meatloaf. Remember, has some rolled oats in it, so I'm still in my macros for the day. So, thank you for tuning in today, and thank you for watching.